Hey everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Civilization 5 Brave New World as friends. So, I'm going to continue where I left off. I switched Paris to production focus, so I'm getting 99 production in here now, but I did lock all the chateaus manually, just to make sure I'm getting the culture and tourism from them. Speaking of tourism, I'm actually going to buy a hotel in Lyon. I'm going to need a hotel in every city for the National Visitor Center, and I won't really have time to build it in Lyon because it will be busy with Sydney Opera House. And I will get some nice tourism from it immediately because I do have a landmark in here. So that's kind of useful. Let's grab it. Alright, now I'm at 57 tourism. Other than that, I also switched Orleans to production focus and I queued up a hydro plant after the archaeologist. Also the public school because it was almost completed. So might as well finish it. Oh, and one more thing I forgot about. I'm going to send my cavalry to Australia. Not just because my archaeologists might need an escort, but also because there's a barbarian camp over here with two city-state quests for it. Which means I can actually get influence with two city-states. I'll send my cavalry to deal with this, and it will also escort my archaeologists. I don't really need to keep it on the antiquity site anymore. I'll be grabbing this antiquity site with my next archaeologist. And this archer will just go back home, really. I'll just send it like this, so I don't have to do it manually every single turn. Alright, and I'll get as many chateaus as possible, because that's always worth a little bit of extra tourism. Not a huge amount, but I will have a hotel in every single city, because I have to. So I might as well get as many chateaus as possible. That's the plan. This dude is actually constructing a mine. Yeah, let's actually interrupt that. I could get a chateau on this tile right here. I could get one on the desert. Let's grab it right here. As for the delegates, oh yeah, that's just a vote for the host. That's going to be England then. Alright, looks good. What are my other workers doing? There's one guy over here, he's removing the jungle. He's actually almost done with that. I don't think he had any more orders after that. I can get a chateau on this tile. That's actually what I'm going to do. And this worker will grab a mine. I could send him to build chateaus too. But I want to get at least one more mine for this city, because it's a little bit low on production. This is also the last opera house that I need for Hermitage. I will get started on Hermitage as soon as I'm done with the Louvre. Then I'll also need Oxford University. I need to finish Oxford University as soon as I get telecommunications, because that's what I will be using for the internet. I also signed one more research agreement with Washington, just in case I'll need it for radar, which I probably will. So that happened. And I got a unit from city-state, nice. Not that I need more land units, but whatever. The AIs will see me as stronger thanks to this. So I suppose that's useful. Let's grab Jill too. And I can send him to my other city down there. And this will be a chateau. As for a cargo ship, let's see what the most profitable trade routes are. I could get a trade route with Spain or Poland. I don't think I have a modifier with Spain for a trade route. I'm actually debating sending a diplomat to Spain, because Spain has a pretty high culture output, they might be a problem. Let's see, oh yeah, I do have a trade route with Spain already, let's send it to Poland then. So since that barbarian camp is still in Australia, I might want to be careful with my archaeologist, I wouldn't want him to get killed. That would be bad, to say the least. Okay, this guy will go down here. I actually need that artifact. I need one more artifact for the theming bonus in the Louvre. I want to get the theming bonus on the same turn I finish Louvre on. That will be worth 8 tourism, I believe, because I can't get airports yet. Attila declared war on Elizabeth, okay. And Shaka declared war on Elizabeth. I'm sure she can handle it. England is actually the second most advanced civilization right now. And they are my ally, more or less. I actually sent my spy to Nottingham instead of some Korean city, whatever it was called, because he will be less likely to get killed in there. And all I really need are some cheap technologies that lead to radar. So that was the safer way to go. Alright, and I can warn Spain, I suppose. This will be a mine. And the cavalry will head to Australia. Alright, and more chateaus. Let's see. Actually, this is... Yeah, I might want to reconsider this. Hold on. I can get one more chateau for Paris. But then I can't get this one. I could get one right here. Yeah, that's going to be much better. I can get two chateaus, here and here. And then work this one with Orleans and this one with Paris. That's much better. I don't want to ban gold, but I don't mind embargoing Spain. I don't really care about Spain. So, four more turns for the Louvre. I don't think anyone will build the Louvre, because I don't think anyone has the exploration opener. No one has any policies in it. I only need four turns. If someone was going to build it, they would have done it a while back. So I'm not really worried about that. Come on. I might actually buy another hotel as soon as I'm done, as soon as I get 1000 gold. Because I have one more landmark down here. And that would give me a little bit of extra tourism, and again, that city has low production. Why can't I go through here? Oh, because Korea is here, okay. What are they doing over there? Share intrigue. Right. I think I need literally four more gold. No, I need a little bit more than that. I could get that gold from Washington. I could sell him some of my resources. Will he buy iron? Yes, he actually will. Okay. That's going to be enough then. Let's see. How much will he give me? Okay, that's enough. No, that's not enough. Can I sell anything else? What can I sell? Let's have a chat with Korea. I don't really want to sell oil. I could maybe sell oil to some weak civilization like Poland. Let's see, one oil or two oil actually. That should be worth 90 gold if I'm not mistaken. What? Oh, he doesn't want oil. Okay, apparently he doesn't. I don't really want to sell aluminium because I kind of need it. I won't be selling uranium either. And I also need coal. I can't sell anything else. I could just wait one turn. And that's probably what I'm going to do. Yes, hello again. Go ahead. Will she buy all? Yes, she will. Oh, she only has 12 gold. Never mind that then. I'm running out of options. I think I'll just wait one turn. It's hardly a big deal. Yeah, let's wait one turn. Another chateau and another chateau. This will take a while because I have to chop the jungle. Grab that antiquity site. That will take 6 turns, no, 4 turns. Good, so that will finish right after I get the Louvre. And England is doing quite well. They captured San Francisco, whatever that is. I don't think I can actually see it. But that's good. Pakal completed Cristo Redentor, I knew he was building it. So whatever, he can have it. I want the Louvre and the Sydney Opera House. And the CN Tower. I'm not sure if I'll have the time to build the CN Tower. Probably after the National Visitor Center. The National Visitor Center is a lot more important. I also need as many chateaus near Paris as possible. I think I can get at least one or two more. I could get one if I replace the farm. I'm not sure if I want to replace the farm, but it's possible. I would lose, what, 2 food? I think I'll do it though, it's not like the city will starve. And even if it will, then I can always send some food with caravans. But yeah, I wasn't going to do it, but I will replace the farm with the chateau. Yeah, 29 gold per turn. I think I want to keep working this trade route. Because I do actually need the gold. Yeah, 33 gold per turn. That's definitely what I'm going to do. So, how are we doing now? I can buy that hotel now, so let's do it. That's going to give me plus 2 tourism only, okay. I guess that's always something. I can't get any chateaus on Madagascar because there are no luxuries. But I needed that hotel anyway, again, for National Visitor Center. I will get a research agreement triggering in 7 turns. That should give me telecommunications, I think. Probably. Other than that... Yeah, not much else to do, I suppose. Let's continue then. 2 more turns for Lover. I'll grab the theming bonus as soon as it's completed. As long as I'll be able to trade the artifacts and great works of art, because the way Lover bonus works, you need 2 great works of art and 2 artifacts, and they all need to be from different civilizations and different eras. Spain wants the creation of friendship. Yeah, sure, why not? I'm like super friendly with everyone, which is kind of funny. They might not be so friendly anymore if I get close to victory. Then again, if I get a lot of influence over them, they will probably flip to freedom. And then I'll get a positive modifier with them, a huge modifier. Alright, I don't want to disembark here because of that barbarian camp. I'll just do it safe and go there. Plus 1 pop in tours. Oh yeah, I can also get a chateau on this desert hill. I could almost use more workers. I should also start upgrading some of these units, just in case someone actually gets any silly idea to attack me. Yeah, let's start upgrading them. I can upgrade them all the way to infantry. And we can get some gold. Let's sell gems for 205 and 1 gold per 10. Very nice. I will upgrade the musketeers all the way to infantry. Where's England going? Probably attacking someone. I could probably get all the AIs to fight each other. I could get England to fight Korea, maybe. I'll try doing that. That would be useful. England is actually the second most advanced civilization. Other than me, that is. I'm the second. England is technically third, but the second most advanced AI. So if someone can challenge Korea other than me, it's probably England. I can try. They do have some submarines, so they could actually hurt these battleships. And England usually builds a lot of ships, because their unique unit is ship of the line. Anyway, there's the Lover, so let's pop these guys. And the other dude. Okay, now we can disembark. Maybe. Can we disembark? Yes, we can. Alright, upgrade this dude. Use this. Now, I think that dig is almost done. Oh, I need 1 more turn. Okay. So I can't get the theming bonus yet. But I can send the 2 more great works to a museum to get instant plus 2. Yeah, these are the ones. So this can go here. Like so. And I'll just wait 1 more turn before I start trading. I'll have to swap a few great works around with other civilizations. So, priorities. I'm going to need Hermitage, but I do want to get that museum. I'll get the museum, then Hermitage, then Oxford. 5 more turns. Let's get started on Oxford and leave it 1 turn until completion. 5 turns. Well, I can build the museum and then get started on Oxford. That seems more reasonable. The hydro plant is almost done. I will finish the public school that I started in Orleans. It's like 4 turns away from completion. Spices. I could probably use some extra happiness if I get a chance to get another golden age in this game. My current golden age will end soon. But with enough happiness, I might be able to get 1 more. This game is going quite well. If it wasn't for Korea, this game would be pretty easy to win, in fact. I'm still a little bit worried about Korea. I'm not sure if I'll be able to slow them down. Especially since I don't really have time to build up a fleet. I would have to give up my culture tourism plan to switch to military production right now. I have to focus on the hotels and museums and archaeologists, because I need that tourism. Oh great, now city-state will block this tile. I can go to the other site, I suppose. I should get 1 more archaeologist. I guess I could get that before the public school. or after the public school. There's no huge rush, I suppose, and I kind of do need radar. The sooner the better. So here's another chateau. Let's just lock this and keep this city on production. Okay, that looks good to me. 22 turns. Well, I will get the Great Engineer in how many? In 10 turns. I don't need 10 turns of Sydney Opera House. I could actually build something else. Let's see. Oh yeah, I don't actually have an observatory in here. Okay. But that won't give me that much science. Probably not worth building at this stage of the game. But what's worth building? A market is definitely worth building. And that's only 3 turns. Right. So, more chateaus. We need all the chateaus. This is going to be a chateau. And this is going to be an upgrade. Alright. Things are looking good. And how's that spy? 17 turns to steal something from England. I might be able to steal something important. Oh yeah, now I can get the artifact. And now we need to get the theming bonus. So let's have a look. We need 2 artifacts. So I have 2 French artifacts from ancient era, which is kind of annoying. I need to trade at least one of them. Let's have a look what's actually available. Classical medieval. Oh, that's perfect. So let's trade this one for Polish classical artifact. And trade the other one for Shaka's medieval artifact. Perfect. Now these go into Louvre slots. That gives me classical and medieval era. Now I need 2 great works of art from eras other than classical and medieval. I can use one French artifact. So, okay, modern and industrial. Let's swap this for something else. I can swap the industrial one for industrial one that belongs to another civilization, and that will work. So, for example, this one, it doesn't matter that much. And this should give me the theming bonus. Because now I'll have 4 items from 4 different eras and 4 different civilizations. Yep, this works. Perfect. That's plus 8. It will be plus 16 once I get the aesthetics finisher. I need one more policy for it, which I will be getting ASAP. And one more thing I'll need in Paris. Oh yeah, it's already queued up. The Musicians Guild. I'll start working on musicians once I get the internet. I should probably get started on that right now. Okay, let's grab the Musicians Guild after the museum then. I only need one more turn for museum. I'll move my artifacts or great works to the museum in Paris as soon as it's completed, because that should give it a bonus. Because I only get the bonus that's part of my unique ability in my capital. So that will give me a tourism bonus. I have 77 tourism. I should be the tourism leader by a fairly significant margin right now. Yep. The Huns are actually second. Oh yeah, that's because they are getting 100% increase from International Games gold reward. No, I don't really need more research agreements. I'd rather keep my gold to buy things. Isabella declared war on Elizabeth. So how's that research agreement? 4 more turns. Alright then. Now we can start excavating this, and my cavalry is almost there. I should get influence with 2 city-states if I get rid of that barbarian camp. Another chateau is done. I'm already working this, but let's make sure by locking it. That looks good. 2 more turns for public school. So I can get a chateau right here. Is this in range of Orleans? Yes, it is. Okay, that works. I can get quite a few chateaus still. I could get one right here, to the west of the spices. And that works quite well. Yeah, I see quite a few potential sites for chateaus still. I will spam them as much as possible. Because that's always a tiny little bit of extra tourism in cities with hotel, which means every single city. Right, anything else to do? I don't think so. I have 3 more turns. So, okay, I think I want the internet before the Musicians Guild. But I suppose it doesn't matter all that much now. If I wanted to optimize it a little bit more, I should have done it earlier. There are a few things I could have done to optimize it a little bit better, but yeah, not now. Open borders? Yes, I do need open borders. But either way, what I could have done is get all the points required for the first great musician, but not pop him. And then unassign them to pop my first one as soon as I get the internet. I wasn't generating great musicians on purpose. The reason is because the tourism bomb is based on your tourism output when that great musician is generated. So you can't just build up great musicians and then use them for tourism bombs once you get internet, because their value will be based on your tourism output when they were generated. This is why I delayed the Musicians Guild, but I should have built it a little bit earlier, just to get enough points, or almost enough points, for that first great musician. Oh, someone took care of the unit in here? Okay. I'm just in time then. Another chateau. And... right, I will switch production one turn before Oxford is completed. Because I have no guarantee that this research agreement will actually pop telecommunications. I think it will, but I'd rather play it safe. I'm almost done with all the hotels. I think this is the last hotel that I needed. I'm pretty sure Orleans already has a hotel. Or does it? Apparently it doesn't, okay. I can get one after the public school then, or I can buy one if I want to. I need to check how many turns I'll need for it. Are we there yet? Yeah, the AI turn is taking a while now. Alright, give me the city-state influence. I'll keep that cavalry in Australia, just to escort my archaeologists. I'm sending one more. There are some more antiquity sites in this general area. So there's one over here, there's one over here. I will send more archaeologists that way. But first, we need that hotel. That's only 4 turns, okay. I won't be spending 1000 for that then. Okay, now I'm going to switch this production to Musicians Guild or to Hermitage. Actually, Hermitage makes more sense because that gives us instant tourism. Okay, looks good. And I still didn't build Circus Maximus, but that's not that important. I can build it in here, actually. Oh yeah, museum. Let's grab that museum. Do I have a hotel in here? I can't see it on the list. Oh yeah, it's already... right, I was building it in here. I should get an armory in at least one coastal city. Yeah. If I want to build a fleet, I'm going to need armories in some of my coastal cities at least. So this is the best option. Okay, next. So, give us telecommunications already. I think I need to wait 2 more turns, not 1 more turn. Because this pops at minus 1, which doesn't make a whole lot of sense, but from what I remember, that's how it works. Come on. Are we there yet? No, I don't need more research agreements. My golden age is about to end. Unfortunately, that makes me sad. We might be able to get one more golden age in this game, we'll see. So, I'll just park the cavalry on top of the archaeologist. There's no reason not to, and we will get a great engineer in 6 turns. I think I have enough production towards the Sydney Opera House by now. I can get something else. So, for example... what do I actually need in here? Let's see, I suppose I could get Circus Maximus. I could get Observatory, but that's not worth enough science, really. And I don't really need science at this point all that much. Let's actually grab Barracks. And maybe then Armory. So, give me that research agreement already. I want my telecommunications. Elizabeth entered Atomic Era. I'll get started on National Visitor Center as soon as that last hotel is finished. Probably after Musicians Guild, I want to finish both Hermitage and Musicians Guild. Because I'll need musicians. For tourism bombs, obviously. Let's have a look at our influence. It's slowly going up. Pakali is going to be the biggest problem here. There's no way he will get eliminated. He still has several cities, so that's just not going to happen. What are my bonuses? Yeah, these three shouldn't really be a problem. I could always get a trade route with the Huns, I suppose. So, come on. Yeah, yeah. What? Oh, I need to wait one more turn. Yeah, as I said, minus one turn. I will change this to Oxford now. I want to get internet as soon as possible. As for the caravan... Oh yeah, that was food to Paris. I think I'll keep adding food to Paris. Because I can't work all the high value tiles. Otherwise... This chateau is not done yet. Hmm. Yeah, if I replace farms with chateaus, I'm actually going to need that food. Alright. One trade route is not really a big deal. I can live without one trade route for gold. As for this city, let's grab barracks. Or museum, or factory. Well, really, if I want to build up a fleet, I'm going to need barracks and armories. In some of my cities at least. So artifact, obviously. And now we will park the cavalry on top of this. Riga won't like us too much, but I don't really care about their opinion. Hey, we'll actually get more influence with Riga when we generate a Great Engineer, and that will kick Poland out. Nice! How's that Great Engineer? 5 more turns. So we will get allied with Riga in 5 turns. Always good to see. So, we will get the internet in 1 turn. Come on. Give us the internet already. Almost there. Oh yeah, he will buy horses, sure, I'm selling. I'm actually surprised that he's buying horses this late into the game. He captured Vatican City, okay. Where is it? Oh yeah, right here. Whatever floats his boat. I might try to bribe as many AIs to fight each other as possible. That might cost me quite a bit of gold, but it would kind of make sense to get everyone involved in a world war. So, it's done. Also got military science. I'll park that cavalry over there. And we can get the internet. And that gives us the tourism boost. 168 tourism. And we'll get more. We will get a lot more. Don't you worry about that. World leader. Well, I'll just vote for myself or whatever. I should have sold that vote. But a little bit too late for that now. As for the policy... Oh yeah, now I should get aesthetics finisher. Yeah, it's actually a little bit late for that, but let's grab that. And that gives us almost 200 tourism. Is that chateau done yet? No, it's not. But it will be done soon. So now I just need Korea not to win, basically. That's what I need. Because winning this game is mostly a matter of time now. I will get even more tourism. Let's have a look at influence real quick. Yeah, this is going well. Obviously, I'm nowhere close to having 100% with anyone yet, but this will go fast now. Alright, what's this about? Oh, nice! Extra growth in my cities? Extra growth in Paris? Well, I can't really make Paris grow anymore. Unless I send multiple caravans with food, which would be a little bit silly. How many turns do I need? Oh, only 6 turns for a National Visitor Center. Okay, that hotel is almost done. Yeah, the National Visitor Center will give me a lot of extra tourism. And I can still keep spamming the chateaus. I can build a chateau right here instead of the farm. Because that's adjacent to a luxury. And not adjacent to other chateaus. I can build one where? Yes, accept. I can build one up here? No, that's not adjacent to a luxury. I think this is the last one, actually. How rude, can't you see I'm busy? Okay, this is actually going to be the last one, other than the one I'm already building. I don't see any more locations available, but that's a lot of chateaus near Paris. I can still keep building chateaus near Orleans. I see at least 2 more locations. This one is done? I can't actually see it, but it's there. I'm already working that, so that's good. I could replace the farm with the chateau if I want to. I think I will. I mean, I really see no reason not to do it. I should spam them everywhere, where possible. So that hotel is done, let's queue up the National Visitor Center. And I would like to get the CN Tower. I'll probably build it once I'm done with this queue. Anyhow, I'm going to finish this part here and continue in next one. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.